Hello all, Terhi here again. I'm playing today with the Hip Kid Club sketch and with December kids. I still have plenty of them lying on top of my work table, so my plan is just to have fun. In this sketch you have one big spot for photograph and then lots of hearts. But I decided, as in our December kids, was a bunch of these little words, text or phrases from Pinkfresh Studio that I really want to use them all. So I'm not going with heart shape, I'm just making these little super teeny tiny clusters all over the page. Just like in the sketch, and that will be the idea for this page. And as I always love lots of layers and doing something, something special for the page, I'm not going to glue them like this. I want to make a little frame for each, a little background paper for each, and I'm going to use this gorgeous watercolor kind of paper, which is designed by our Hip Kid Club design team member Irit Langgraf. I don't know if I say the name right, but anyway, she's so super talented scrapbooker and mixed media artist, and I really love her designs. She has made couples of exclusive papers for Hip Kid Club, and I just can't wait what she have in her mind for future, because these are so fabulous that if she has a spot for design some other products too in future, I'm really looking forward to see them. But anyway, I'm using this paper and I'm going to use all the colors. I'm not going to be just with the pink or blue. I want to use it all. I want lots of colors, especially because these colors are quite light. They are not so vibrant and dark colors, so it's easy to use a lot of them. As you can see, when I'm going to cut something thin, I'm using my scissors. Even though I have my paper trimmer here, as you see, but no, I just can't use it. Or yes, I can, but I'm more comfortable with scissors. It's just so much funnier, and I love the feel of paper in my hands. So when I'm preparing these, I'm using I'm using 3D foam, which is kind of thin 3D foam, because I want to have some shadow underneath the text or word or phrase, whatever it is. And I even have these little different shaped than square or rectangle. This nice is like an arrow, and epic is half of circle, but they all match together so well. I also picked up some other things that I might want to use on this layout, but first I'm designing how to set all these little clusters and how to make the clusters out of them. There was lots of ephemera from Vicky Pudding, all the good things line, which I adore, and I'm almost picking up the birdie for this one. But then, no, the bird was too much, as this layout is going to be really fresh and light and everything like that. Just as the ones in the photograph. That's my youngest daughter, who had her birthday party in this, what's the word in English, this kind of playground thing inside a house. Lots of things to jump on, and well, anyway, really, really lots of movement for every children there was. So it was a happy and sweaty day, and I'm happy to make this layout about it. Now I'm thinking about if I'm going to set the nice word there or not, or will I put the bird or not, or will I set this leaf down there or not. But I want to have this happened phrase for the page, but it's tricky to decide how. But once I'm finished with the designing part and made the final decisions, I'm going to do the words more like the clusters would be. And I'm not going to use a lot of paper for this or anything. It would be too noisy. So that's why I'm just going to use these quite big star stickers. These are also from Pink Fresh Studio, and I love them. I'm just putting one different color underneath each phrase, so that there's something making shadows, making layers. And these are a bit tricky to take the triangles off from the center of each edge, but we will manage. Just use your nails or use your scissors and you will be just fine. But this is a good example, the whole layout, about how you can be inspired by the sketch, but you don't have to be exactly like a sketch. As this sketch could be rotated, and as in the original one there was hearts, you don't have to use hearts, you can use whatever you want to use. But sometimes the sketches are good for giving inspiration, because sometimes I feel a bit lost, so having a sketch is an easy way to start. And after this layout I made a bunch of more because I was so excited and kind of got my mojo back, and that was fun. I decided to change that no blue star under blue paper and so on. Changing the colors is always good. And then I want to add a little stitch star next to the title. I really love the little stars. They have a golden cardstock underneath the vellum and then some stitching, and they are so cute. Also, I saved these other edges from the tags I cut. The wow totally in O, and the one next to the photograph. Anyway, I saved them and I'm going to put them between the paper layers, because this is how I can make a little visual lie by adding these, and you will think that there's a couple of tags underneath the photograph, and there isn't. Haha, what a good joke. Anyway, this was really fresh and easy and really quick layout to do. Not much of mixed media, as you can see, just few drops of mist, and in my opinion this is not mixed media at all. But sometimes it's nice to make a layout with a quick and easy way. And I hope you are inspired, and if you have time, go ahead and play along in HipKid Club member forum in Facebook. And I'm looking forward to see what you are creating. So thank you for so much. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope we'll see you soon again. Have a happy day. Thank you. Bye.